indication that Vader and the Patriot are set for the flag match at WWF Bad Blood in St. Louis.
And when these four men collide, only two will walk out, as someone is going to have to capture their country's flag and wave it high to win that match. And Patriot and Vader plan on it being Old Glory.
I'll tell you what, Jim, this, talking about collisions, this matchup will be a collision. 458-pound Vader, 300-pound Sultan going at it in the middle of the ring. Talking about the Hart Foundation, I'm sure they're going to be in the house. Madison Square Garden this Monday. Bret Hart at one point in time called it his house. I wonder if Vader's going to have anything to say about that.
Well, if Madison Square Garden is Bret's house, then Vader's going to be guilty of some breaking and entering, just like he's trying to break everything in Sultan's face right now. He's hitting Sultan so hard, he's going to close what's open and open what's closed.
Vader going to work now on the Sultan, Jim. I'll tell you what, I cannot wait for Raw is War in the Garden on Monday. If you haven't got your tickets yet, we may have some good news. We're going to be giving you a phone number a little later on in the program. There may be some seats available come Monday because the WWF production crew is moving in this weekend. We may have some seats available, so we'll find out on Monday.
Oh!
What a move by Vader off the second rope.
Boy, I'm going to tell you what, this Vader is more powerful, meaner, more aggressive than we've seen him in a long time. And believe me, I know Vader real well. You know, the thing is, he's not friends with the Patriot. He doesn't want any man to like him, but he demands that every man respect him and that all his opponents fear him. And the one thing, like you said, that he and Patriot have in common is that they're both Americans, and they hate the Hart Foundation.
Here's a cover. There's two. The Sultan gets that right shoulder up. You see the Iron Sheik at ringside. He's been working with the Sultan over the past few months.
And once again, you can never tell about Vader. He's a time bomb waiting to go off. He's very combustible. He's got a he's got a short fuse. And if you make this guy mad, anything can happen. I wouldn't be the Hart Foundation in their shoes, but also Patriot better carry his end of the load.
We were speaking of Ahmed Johnson a little bit earlier. He returns from his injury. He's back in action in the Intercontinental Tournament at Raw this Monday. It was Ahmed Johnson who put the Sultan out of commission for a few months, injuring his ribs back in the spring. Vader now being raked across the top of that rope by the man from the Middle East. The Sultan giving the man they call Vader a battle this week.
Well, right now, you know, Sultan's a big boy, and he's definitely powerful, and he's taking it to Vader, and that's what you've got to do. You've got to hit Vader and keep on hitting him, because if you stop hitting him, then something bad's going to happen. Namely, Vader's going to hit you.
Here comes the Sultan now outside the ring. Vader trying to shake the cobwebs out of his head, and he did. Here he comes down with the left and right hand. This is what Vader does best, but the Sultan rakes his eyes. And now Vader again in a little bit of trouble.
Wait a minute. Looks like Sultan's rearing up and boom, right into the steel ring steps.
Vader, the All-American football player from Colorado, also played in the NFL with the Los Angeles Rams, where he earned a Super Bowl ring. Looked like he was hitting a lineman that time.
Well, he rammed those steps, but the steps didn't even put him down. This guy, he's got a tremendous balance for a man that size, and once he's up, he's hard to take off his feet.
Reversal now, Sultan into the ropes. Vader with a big clothesline, and the Sultan a 360 in the air. He's in la-la land. Vader now looks like he's going to go up to the second rope here. This could be the Vader bomb, Jim. You know this move well.
And Vader's going to bring all